We so desire to enter your courts tonight.
Yes.
Into your presence. We thank you that you're so good. You're so amazing. I just ask, Father, as we worship you, that you would fill this room with angels.
Yes.
With your love, your joy, your peace, your goodness, your kindness. We just ask that we'd be able to encounter heaven tonight in this place. Encounter your presence. Enable us tonight, Father, to go places where we've never gone before in worship. In Jesus' name.
Picture in your mind the 10-meter diving board like in the Olympics. And if you're, pay attention to your emotions right now, because you're the diver. So either you're afraid of heights, your heart is beating out of your chest right now because you're about to make this dive, or you've been rehearsing it over and over and over in your mind, and you're ready to do it. Wherever you're at, he meets you. And turns and all this incredibly amazing looking stuff. Again, wherever you're at, that's where he's going to meet you. But you get to choose to dive into the deep end with him. The one guarantee is that you will not be hurt. Even your belly flops, you're not going to get hurt.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father, that the guest of honor is here. Jesus. Wow. Thank you for your presence in this place tonight, Father. Just thank you for the peace that's in this place, the love that's in this place, the joy. Father, we give you everything that happens here tonight. May it bring you glory and honor. And Lord, I just ask that the faith level in this room, it's already high, but that it would even go higher. That faith would be so activated tonight that we would have an expectancy to encounter heaven in this place tonight. Father, thank you. I just thank you, Father, for a group of people whose hearts are so set on you. For real worshipers, Father. I thank you that you search for those who would worship in spirit and truth. And I know you found us in this place tonight. Thank you, Father. We love you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Wow, can we thank the amazing worship team? Wow.
In the beginning.
So, you know, I don't really play poker, but I have a couple of times. Isn't a full house a good hand? We got a good hand here tonight, huh? You know, as we need to put together a worship night.
Yeah.
It's like, oh my goodness, that was so fun. We need to just, what did we do, 6 hours last time? January, is that what we're thinking?
Yeah.
Can we wait? I don't know.
Better practice.
Wow. You know, there's nothing like being in a room with a bunch of worshipers.
That's right.
Wow. And I'm thinking, Lord, can we just stay here all night and just encounter heaven in this place? You know, I was talking to somebody about Scotland and, was it you, Rick?
Yeah.
I was talking to you about Scotland and how there was this place, and I can't remember how you pronounce the name, but it was an open field, and there was a stream that went through it, and they had somewhere between estimated 20 to 30,000 people there, and this was before they had amplification. They started preaching at 12 noon, and two preachers kept taking turns. And at 3 in the morning, they tried to dismiss everybody and nobody would leave.
Wow.
And they said it looked like a battlefield. People were laid out all over. I mean, honestly, that's how I feel tonight. It's like, oh, Lord, it's just so good to be in your presence. And I know we have to work tomorrow, and, you know, things have to take place, but my goodness. Thank you for leading us in worship, you guys. That was just fantastic. I did ask a few people to seek the Lord on getting some words of knowledge for healing during worship. Did anybody get anything about it? Did you? I forgot to ask you. Oh, you did? What did you write down? God is good?
All the time.
Yeah,
good.
Yeah, you got several?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Crossing the chicken line.
Hopefully it won't be fried chicken.
Now, okay. Is there somebody named Christian here? That's your given name? Not that I'm a Christian, but
yeah. I am one of those.
All right. And does the date 12-3 mean anything to anybody? December 3rd?
That's
your birthday?
Yeah.
Okay, maybe that's it. sure. This sounds dumb. The word I heard was sleeves. Like, and I thought, well, is that the song Green Sleeves? I'm not sure what that means. But sleeves or green sleeves, I'm not sure. But what I heard was, what I thought I got on this one was industrial accident.
Oh.
Did you ever, had some kind of accident?
Oh, routine? Did you say December 3rd?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's my birthday.
That's
oh,
birthday?
Rick's birthday too. You guys share a birthday.
Well, anyway. Both of you stand up. The thing I thought I got, and I'm still
you
learning.
You want him to stand?
Yeah, just stand up.
Please.
We'll just do a cover everybody.
Go, Rick!
Maybe this was somebody out there in TV land, but I thought I heard industrial accident. Maybe somebody had some kind of industrial mishap on the job or something. And God sees what happens, and he wants you well again. So I just felt like, Lord, whoever that is, I pray for healing, that that industrial accident will be completely non...
Well, since we have these two standing, we better prophesy over them.
Yeah.
So let's go after that. So, Father, Steve had that date, so you want to bless these two? And Amy needs to stand up.
Yes, she does.
So, Lord, just give us some real quick prophetic words for them, Lord. That would be awesome. Yeah, so I got something for you, Rick. I saw you actually on a ladder, and I felt like it was actually a ladder under a tree. You were picking some apples. And I felt like the Lord saying this is a season where he's taking you higher, and you're going to actually... I just feel like there's... You felt like you've invested. This is actually the season where you're going to get the fruit of your investment.
Yes.
Yeah, and it's actually going to come from a place of where the Lord's taking you just like... higher in the sense spiritually. I see that he's taking you a new place in the spirit with him, and you're going to be gathering fruit in that place. And I felt like that a lot of it was things that you had invested over the years. I don't know if it's just physically or spiritually, one or the other, maybe both. So,
good.
Bless you with that. Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know what this means anything, but I just thought it's interesting that 12-3 is 1-2-3.
Oh, yeah.
And I was kind of thinking, you know, like 1-2-3, go. Or 1-2, you know, there was a launching. Or there was, anyway, so I just thought 1-2-3, and maybe this is a time to release something.
Did somebody say diving board? Yeah, because I saw a diving board too. So I was trying to figure out what that meant.
Yeah.
So,
and I saw
you too?
Yeah. And I saw you leading a charge. So that goes along with that. Yeah, leading a charge.
Okay.
Cool.
The industrial accident, I think, was industrial revolution. And these two are involved in leading the charge in a new revolution.
That's so good.
Yeah. I know. I actually think this is what I'm saying.
Hey.
So what I saw is I saw a desert scene, and I saw a blue Land Rover, and you were in it, and it's like you didn't know where you were going, but you were at peace, and it was literally morning as the sun was coming up. I could see it rising on the horizon, and I felt like the Defender was just who you are in the spirit, and the blue vehicle with an open top, you just have an open heaven with the Lord, and the Lord is defending you, and also you defend the land, and you seem like you're in a desert season. Literally mourning, like you're in a season of mourning, and but the Lord says joy comes in the morning. You just keep heading toward the sun, and he saw you moving toward the sun, and just like there was like this wind coming through you, and like a freedom filling you, and a lightness filling you the closer you got to him as you drove toward the sun. And so I just think it's a word for you that you're in the right place. Just keep driving and heading toward the sun, because joy is literally coming in the morning. And though you're in mourning now, there will soon be.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yes. Can I get one? Yeah. Is that all right? Yeah, and Amy, for you, what I saw you as a battleship, and the Lord was actually the one, and I hear the word governing the guns. I don't even know why that word comes to me, but I see him shooting the guns. You're the ship, and he's actually warring for you. And I heard that he's, how do I put this in nice words? Blowing the crap out of the enemy. For you.
Come on.
Yeah, one other quick thing. I thought I heard the name Jeannie. I know Jeannie Fuller isn't here, and I wasn't thinking.
She may be watching.
Maybe she's watching. If so, what I had was, maybe this is for you guys, it's kind of an old thing, all encompassing thing. Sometimes the scripture that came was sometimes God, it's about God causes the rain to fall on the just and the unjust. And it's, the thing I got was, it's your season for the rain to fall. He's up to some kind of, it's up to some kind of watering and refreshing. It's a time of refreshing in your life. So it's about him bringing times of refreshment. And today I was driving to the post office, and there's a completely blue sky to the north, and there's a complete rainbow all the way across. A brilliant rainbow against a completely blue sky. No clouds above. I've never seen anything like that. It's kind of like there's blue skies coming and God's promises. So,
yes. Bless you guys for that.
Yeah.
Thanks for taking a risk, Steve. And then,
I got something.
Okay.
During worship.
For healing?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. Two things. Is that
You want to come up here?
Bring it.
Two things are better than one.
Yeah. Why is this good?
I hope it's for the Oregon Ducks. Can we release something?
During worship, I received a word for somebody here. I believe. So the vision that I had was a gentleman in a cave with locked bars on a cliff. And the sea is below. So just a real trapped feeling. And then after that vision, I saw, I felt like the Lord said, just reach your hand up. You forgot to look up.
Wow.
There's a key right there.
Oh my gosh. Oh,
wow.
And so, and I felt like this was a season of Psalms 88 for this gentleman, where he's heard your cry. You'll want to read that. And then he just feels like, I just felt like you're his light, and he wants to send you out. He wants to get you out. And then the other, so if that's for you, I just release that and bless you with that. Just be the light and find that key and have fun. And then, and then the other one was, I felt like I was supposed to pull down a healing of an emotion that has gotten me stuck from seeing God the way that that he wants to be so close to you. He's not this big giant where you're just crawling at his feet to get to his face to kiss him. He wants to be close to you, and he wants to have that, he wants to heal you of that emotion.
Did you read my notes?
No. From heaven for each one of your children here today, for their emotion that is keeping them hindered from you, Lord. In Jesus' name, I just pray, in precious name, amen.
Amen. Wow, that's so good. Anybody else have a, Janet.
I think I have a picture of the different things people were saying.
You want to come up here?
There's different elements in there, different things people are saying. One of them you were saying about raining down from heaven. And those could be the tears of the Lord. It could be the living water coming down. And this could be the encompassing, like the presence healing. You can see the person in the arms of the Lord being healed. And I don't know, I just saw different things in the picture that seemed to match some of the things people were saying.
Well, that's good. Thank you. Wow. Cindy.
Does anyone have a right shoulder issue?
That's exactly the word of knowledge I have. Right here on the right shoulder.
Yeah. Anyone? Janet?
There it is. Okay.
Rex
does.
Yeah.
Right shoulder here. Okay.
Okay.
So those around them, lay hands on them.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe they can stand up.
And here's the thing, when I pray for somebody, I always ask them, I pray fairly quickly, and then I ask them, okay, what's going on? And if they're starting to feel a little bit of relief, we thank Jesus, and then we really press in. If they're not feeling any relief, then we really press in. So either way, we just press in. You want to lead in prayer for that?
Yeah, Father, thank you. You reveal and you heal. So we thank you for right shoulder healing today. And we just pull it down, the resources from heaven. And we ask you, Father, right now to bring total healing. The pain would leave. The stress would leave the area. In Jesus' name.
So check it out. Who's getting relief?
Rex.
Yeah, Rex.
Yeah, he's feeling good.
Are you getting relief? Yeah. Janet, any relief? Yeah. Pete, do we need to go after it a little more? Is the pain gone?
Well, it's a pain that wakes me up at night.
Yes.
But right now you don't have it? So, Jim, have you noticed the difference yet? So begin to declare, you guys. One of the other things, when I pray for somebody, I use Jesus' prayers as an example. He just declared healing.
Yes.
You know, and so we just declare healing right now on Jim's right shoulder. Release the power of the Holy Spirit. We speak to strain and we say be gone in Jesus' name. We speak to trauma and we say be gone in Jesus' name right now. Peace. Any shift yet, Jim? Not yet. Well, let's go. Let's be the persistent widow. Yeah. So, Jesus, we just thank you that there are times you ask us to be persistent, and that's what we're doing.
Yeah.
And so we declare healing because you are the healer. You didn't deny anybody healing in the scriptures, and you're the same yesterday, today, and forever. So we thank you for that. And we bless Jim's shoulder. Complete healing and restoration in Jesus' name. Feeling anything going on there yet? Not yet. We're going to just release fire on him. Fire on the shoulder, Lord. Fire, fire. Yeah, we burn away the chaff of the enemy right now. We command this shoulder to be pain-free and to be flexible and fluid in Jesus' name. Any shift yet? Yeah, do it while he sleeps, Lord.
Yes.
Did you have more?
Awesome.
Okay.
Is there
awesome.
Autoimmune is what I heard. Is anybody dealing with any autoimmune? Maybe.
My daughter.
Anybody else? Do anyone know what an autoimmune is? It can be a vast array of different types of itises and symptoms.
And it's where your immune system is actually going against your own body.
It could be even allergies or something like lupus, or it could be, yeah, something like that. So.
Is asthma autoimmune?
Asthma, it kind of could be, yeah, because it's an overactive immune system. So, yeah, let's.
So gather around these guys. Let's go after that.
Yep. Lay your hands on those folks around you.
Is Galv one of those? Is Galv one of those?
Galv, yeah. It could be arthritis. Arthritis, yeah. Arthritis.
Galv. So we release the healing anointing into this atmosphere. The immune systems to love the body well. Immune systems. I'm into alignment with the way Jesus created you. Love your body well, immune system, starting right now. Starting right now. The way Jesus created you. come into alignment. This one's probably hard to tell. And I bless Brian back in the corner. And I speak to Brian's immune system. And I command you to come into alignment the way Jesus created you. Thank you, Lord. No more diabetes. Thank you, Lord. We bless that body. Thank you, Lord. We bless every immune system in this room right now in Jesus' name. Amen. Yeah, Keith.
I'm pretty sure I got my tinnitus and my ears were healed during worship.
Wow, did you guys hear that? Keith's tinnitus and his ears were healed during worship. Wow, so yeah, we bless that. God is good. Alyssa, would you come up here, please? I better lower this. Or... can I hold those for you?
Okay, so I did not know what a frog was, but I did my best.
I knew that was a frog.
So you're like the frog, and like these pads, lily pads, they're like the people that are close to you, that are special to you, and like if you don't feel like safe with one of them, then you just hop to the next.
I love that. Sometimes that's the right answer, isn't it? I don't feel safe with you. I'm hopping somewhere else. So good. And? Oh, that was just a word for him? Who needs this? Or who just wants it? Permission to hop. That's so good. Woo! Goes that way.
So, all these, what are they called? Brains?
Things? Oh, beads.
So they're like things that God told you to do, and if you don't do them like in the row that God tells you to do, then they'll crack. Like on this, you like did these good, like you did it in a good like order.
Good order, the way that God told you to do it.
Yeah, but if you skip ahead, then it'll stumble.
So you're basically telling us that God has a reason for doing things the way he does them. And don't skip ahead, but just trust him. Oh, I got it. That's so cool. Who wants that? Who needs that reminder? Take that back to Stacy. I think that's a good reminder for all of us.
Yeah.
I think we'll just let Alyssa preach.
Yeah.
Come on, Alyssa.
So, you know, Sid had something that he felt like the Holy Spirit laid on his heart. So.
Hey, Sid.
Turn it off. I think it's on. Oh, it's not on. It could be that I need to change the battery.
Ron just got a big boy voice.
And you guys just looked at me. You didn't say, I'm going to another living
Okay. Blessed are the peacekeepers, for they will be called children of God. Who wants to be a peacekeeper? Who wants to be children of God?
Yes.
I'm so proud. Yes. I really felt this really strongly over there. It's interesting, the autoimmune system is like your body divided against itself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I think that the a house divided against itself can't stand. And I feel like the church is a little divided against itself right now. Yeah. Obviously, there's almost like a civil war within the church over this whole election thing. Mm-hmm. It's interesting, like a month or two ago, I had a dream where I met the Leviathan spirit, and you don't ever want to meet that spirit. It's pretty nasty.
Yeah.
Leviathan spirit? In short, I've never seen it before. It's like ridiculous. In short, Leviathan is the king of pride. And the vision is primarily based on pride. That's where it comes from. And I just kept getting things, pictures, flashes of pictures from the Lord over there. And, you know, with all this, even after the election, all this assassination of character of Hillary and Clinton, or I mean Trump and before, it's just not the God's heart. And
that's
God
right.
kept showing me heroes of the faith and the word and how actually flawed they are.
Mm-hmm.
And they were. You think about any, go back and look at any hero of the faith
yeah.
and the stuff they did, and you're like,
yeah.
I like to take David for example,
yeah.
because he was literally a rapist and a murderer.
Yep.
And he's and Jesus himself is called Son of David, every once in a while. Solomon, one of his books is in the Bible. Two of his books are in the Bible.
Right.
You know, in the end of his life, he was sacrificing children to Ashtoreth and Baal.
Thank you.
He was married to women who did that. They turned him away. But his books in the Bible, we learned from them today. God doesn't look at what you look at. And so he also showed me a picture of Saul. And like Saul, who murdered Christians, he was just hell-bent on it. Like, and he felt very righteous in what he did.
Mm-hmm.
Overnight, the Lord changed his heart.
Yeah. Yeah.
So who are we to sit there and throw dirt at people? It's so arrogant. Like, it's so arrogant. And this sounds harsh, and it is, but the Lord corrects the ones he loves. And we all talked about, last time I spoke, remember, everyone wanted to go higher with the Lord.
Yeah.
So this is some of that refining fire. And I think the Lord really wants to deliver us all from the spirit of Leviathan, because it's going to divide the house. And we are supposed to be peacemakers. Right?
Amen.
And, so yeah, we're going to do that.
Hey.
If you want to. I mean, if you want to hang on to it. The door's right there. But I'm on a joke, but it's serious. So, I always forget how we want to do this. Okay. So, Leviathan, the king of pride, slippery. It's a water spirit. It hides under the surface all the time, and it's really slippery. And we just need to get rid of it. So I just want you right now, if you want to join in, just agree with me in prayer in your own words. You can whisper to the Lord, I don't care what you do, but we're going to repent for the spirit of pride because it's going to keep our house from troubling. I think Alyssa actually kind of drew a picture of that. There. So Lord, we just ask for forgiveness for making agreements with pride and the spirit of Leviathan, and we just break off any connection to that spirit, Lord God, and we go humbly before you, Lord God, because you do not look at what man looks at, Lord God, but you look at the heart. You set up kings and you take down kings, Lord God, and you do not pick us and choose us for our own righteousness, Lord God, but you extend us grace as a free gift to every man, Lord God. We just humbly receive that, and we get on our knees, in our Lord, right now before you, and we just ask for forgiveness for pride, Lord God, and that would cause division in your house, Lord God, in your body. All right, and so the next part of this, you know, this is a prophetic house, and the Lord doesn't do anything until he tells his prophets, right? We literally speak it out, act it out, live it out. I'm a physical prophet sometimes, and I really feel like that's why I'm struggling with this autoimmune thing, because the body is divided against itself right now. So it kind of sucks, so we should all get over it. So I'm giving this view. No, so literally, I feel like the Holy Spirit says, who will take up the task? It's your job to intercede and declare into this, because this is a prophetic house, and it's time to lay down our prejudices and agendas, because Jesus said, those who love him obey his commands, and his command is to love one another.
Amen.
You know, over and over, I can't stop playing my own worship time at home. Humble thyself in the sight of the Lord and him lift you up. This keeps coming back to me. And there's a verse, I think it's Jacob when he wrestled with the angel. He asked, when the angel showed up, he said, who are you? He said, I'm the angel of the armies of the Lord. And he said, are you for me or for my enemy? He said, neither.
Right. Yeah. No.
Neither. God doesn't care. He's not worried if you're right. Like, he is not impressed with your theology.
That's good.
The only agenda he follows is his own. Mm-hmm. You know, the angel of the Lord is for what the Lord's doing. We need to jump on board with that. So I think that I just want to commission everybody, those who will accept it and make a promise and a vow in their hearts, to spread peace and unity in the body right now. Because that is what the Lord is doing, and he's looking for people right now that can do that. Because we do not want the body to fight against itself. But those who want to lay down their own agenda and just extend love to their brother and not try to impress them with their prophetic brilliance, or they're being right, just to extend the love of the Lord to them.
Yeah.
If you guys want to do that, I just mean, you commit to that. Don't do it if you don't want to, because it's serious. The Holy Spirit's marking all of you right now. The spiritual realm is marking you all right now. I guarantee it. I prophesy it. That's what's happening right now. I know the angels are on board with this, because that's what the Lord's doing. All right, you are all marked to spread peace.
Yes!
And the word is, if you're not doing that, it's not going to go well with you, because you just committed. And Lord, I'm just going to say a year of that, and then at least from that vow.
Glory!
Good words, Jim.
Wow. Yeah.
I know.
Raquel. That's a Pepsi cup. I used to work for Pepsi. Is this for me? What do you feel like the Lord's saying in this? So she drew this. She felt like Holy Spirit said, this is for somebody. You're hungry and thirsty for God, and it's right in front of you. Who wants this? All of us? Yeah, Jan, you were the first one, I think. Well, it's so good. Oh, let's see. Boy, my message. This could be the shortest message in history, and we still have to take offering.
Yeah.
Yes.
So let's do it. Father, we just thank you for blessing us. You're so good to us. Wow, we live in such a marvelous nation. Lord, we are a blessed people, and we owe it all to you. And so just thank you for this opportunity to give into your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen. And we've got a number of people that are struggling with sicknesses, the health. And so we're going to pray for them really quick. We have Cindy Lee.
Kamara.
Jeanette.
Janelle.
We got an update on Kamara.
She's doing better.
Yes. Oh, Kamara. Oh, yeah. Well, I guess I could say.
Yeah.
The MRI showed nothing.
No cancer.
No tumor, no sign of anything in her lymph nodes or in the original place where it was.
You know, one of the words we got last time we were at Bethel was that Epic would be a cancer-free zone. Come on. That's so good. Who else?
As far as being sick,
Jeanette, my mom, Cindy Lee,
Lord, we just declare healing for
everybody,
every body to be healed in Jesus' name. We declare that their body would line up to a kingdom perspective.
That's right.
And there is no disease. There's nothing bad in the kingdom of heaven. So we just call heaven on earth right now in Jesus' name. And we say, all bodies be healed. Be healed.
Amen.
And just a couple of announcements.
Global Legacy.
Yeah, Global Legacy.
I have an announcement. My wife has ink on her hands. I'll be prepared for that.
Global Legacy Central Oregon is this weekend here. The Bethel Healing Team will be here. And they'll be here Friday night at 7. And then Saturday, they'll be at the Healing Rooms with you guys. Surprise!
Boom!
And then they're going to have a session from 2 to 4, 4 o'clock to 6 o'clock. We have a potluck here, of course. And then 6 o'clock, we'll have another session. And then Sunday, instead of streaming Bethel, they will speak at Epic on Sunday morning. And then, Sue, do you want to say a little bit about that?
Sure. Awesome.
Okay. So if any of you haven't gotten an invitation to the Christmas party, having an old-fashioned Christmas, not next not next Tuesday, but the following Tuesday, the 29th mm-hmm. of November. And we're going to have a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And bring your favorite holiday dish. So if we end
That's
up
my with... wife. Now, gentlemen, that's what you do to get points. Just to teach you the moment.
So also, Don and I chatted about, instead of the $5 gift that we exchange, I was thinking maybe we could just pool all that money and then bless our neighbors on either side for putting up with us all this time.
Or just Brent Coors Light.
Oh, okay. Well, that'll
make him happy.
There you go. That'll make him happy. And I have a word of knowledge.
Yeah.
I have a couple. So, pain in the neck. Does anyone have a pain in the neck?
Three.
Okay. So, can we gather around? And I'll just pray quickly because I know we're running out of time, but I know that's really beautiful. So, Lord, we just ask that you would take this pain from the neck, release all the muscles that are tense and tight,
yes.
And if any of the bones are out of alignment, Lord, we just ask them to come into alignment,
yes.
And we just bless them, yes. And we just bless them in Jesus' name, with complete restoration in their neck and their spine, and they also have like a lower back kind of crimpy.
Here.
Okay. Yeah.
That's super painful. Or close the angel right there.
Yeah. Yeah. Complete restoration.
Blessing.
Approaches.
Okay. Yeah, Lord, go after the hip right now.
Yes, right now.
So,
get these guys. Get these guys.
All tension release.
No more pains in the neck. And the hip. We command all inflammation to go down in the hip right now. We speak to nerve supplies. We say be restored right now in Jesus' name. We free up nerves right now in Jesus' name. That was actually one of the first healings that I ever saw many, many years ago was... yeah, what do you call that? Sciatic.
Ashley, can you come here for a minute?
We bless Rose's body and release the healing power of the Holy Spirit right now. We command her hip to come into alignment now in Jesus' name. Complete healing and restoration. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Yay.
Thank you, Lord.
I just wanted to real quickly introduce my new PA.
Yay!
When the Lord works with us and we're kind of shy and calls us to step out a little bit and do fun stuff. And Ashley this afternoon said, I want to be brave. I want to be brave. She's super shy or like introvert. She used to be.
Oh, yeah.
That was yesterday.
But she asked me this afternoon if she could start doing announcements so that she could start getting used to speaking in front of people. Now, how brave is that? So for the next, I don't know, several Tuesdays, we're just going to have her start doing announcements.
Okay.
And you guys just rock her world because I know she's going to rock yarn.
Yeah.
Yay.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
So here we go. This could be the shortest message ever.
Amen.
Who was that? Brian, I thought you and I...
I meant that was the message. This would be the shortest message.
I'm going to a new lily pad, my friend. Did that ever hurt? Well, you know, Donna actually spoke a few weeks ago on heavenly perspective with body, soul, and spirit. I don't know if you guys, how many of you remember that? But afterwards, somebody came to me and said, so what does a heavenly perspective look like for those things? When I said, well, I'm going to have to just teach on that, I guess. And that person's not here tonight. But, so, you know, I really felt like there was something on that, that the Lord wanted me to go after that. And I wanted to start with the mind tonight, a mind that's focused on a heavenly perspective. And what I want to do, I want to talk about what that looks like. And then the second part is I want to show you how to get there. And I met some guys for breakfast on Monday morning, and one of the words that a guy gave me, a friend of mine from California who was up, he said, I just see you discipling people and just telling them how you live life. And I thought, isn't that good? You know, that should be really simple, right? But I remember Eric Johnson telling his story. He was a really good baseball player when he was younger. And then, you know, as he got older, somebody asked him to coach. And he really didn't know how. Because he did what he did and didn't know how to really teach anybody else to do it. And, you know, as I got that word on Monday morning, that's yesterday morning, that's what I was thinking of. Lord, what do I do? And how do I do that? And I'm not bragging or anything, but I think my wife and I go through life as good as anybody I've ever seen.
I think so
too. And it's like, Lord, how do we do that? I mean, that's the question I'm asking. How do we do that? I can remember in Mexico, you know, a sinkhole formed, and part of the building next to ours went in the sinkhole, and part of our building began to crack, and we had 24 hours to get out of our building. Yeah. And, of course, when all those things happen, my wife's always in the United States. You know, I went through a couple hurricanes down there, and she was up here during both of them. But
do you need a soap company?
I probably do. But I remember a guy that claimed to be a Christian who lived in the building next to ours said, how are you going through this with this much peace? And I was in peace. You know, yeah, I needed to pack up my house and get out of there, but I was in total peace. And what I want to do is really kind of talk about what we do, how our journey is, because, you know, I don't get out of peace very often, you know, and if I do get out of peace, I get back in it really quick. And, you know, we've seen lots of crazy things happen, and we were missionaries in Mexico for 8 years. Come on, we've seen some crazy things and dealt with some crazy things, and, you know, not that we're perfect, but I just kind of want to go on this journey of figuring out, Lord, I live this way in peace and expectancy and excitement and this connection with you, and how do I help others to do that? And so I'm just thinking out loud right now. I really expected to cover a lot of ground tonight, but I can see maybe for the first time in my life I'm going to do a series. I got enough notes here for a series, especially if I only get a few minutes. But I just really want to just talk about how we get there. And I actually, oh, there's my notes. I was way down on my notes. I'm thinking that isn't what I was. You know, Romans 12:2 is what I want to start out with. I love the book of Romans. Anybody else love Romans?
Yeah.
Yeah, Romans is really good. Oops. I just got to find it. I know it's here. I know it's here somewhere. There it is. And this is a real well-known scripture, but it says, do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good and pleasing and perfect will. I just love the second part. I love all of that, but as he's talking about being transformed by the renewing of your mind, then you can test what God's good and perfect will is. It's as our mind is renewed. And you know, sometimes I think in the church we've thought of this thing of the mind being renewed as we just know, we know all the scriptures. But that's not it. It's really living from a heavenly perspective. It's living from a different place than we used to. You know, we know when we come to Jesus, we're a new creation. Immediately. You know, we're seated in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. We're a spiritual being. We're aliens, Paul says, here on this earth. And our actual home is in heavenly realms, right? You know, that happens immediately. But the transforming of the mind doesn't happen immediately. There's a renewal that takes place, and it's a process. And so I want to really look at what does that transformed mind look like? You know, what does it look like to live life from a heavenly perspective? And even as I was praying about this, I'm thinking, you know, we are seated in that place in heaven right now. And really, everything that we think about should come from that position.
That's right.
You know?
Yes.
And it's like, I was thinking, well, you know, Jesus prayed that the Father's will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So whatever's taking place in heaven should be taking place here, right?
That's right.
And so it's coming from that perspective of heaven and understanding we are with the Lord and whatever's going on in heaven should be happening here. I mean, if there's something happening contrary to that, we're still seated up here, and things should shift. Things should change if we've got the right perspective and not just come into agreement with what's going on here. I don't know if that makes sense. It didn't to me. But if you guys got some out of that. So, you know, sometimes I just kind of ramble on what's coming out, and it comes out, and I'm like, oh, maybe that makes sense. I don't. But the first piece of having a heavenly perspective is understanding that God is always near. You see, I see people all the time that forget that God's right next to them, right in them, actually.
Right, right.
You know, I mean, there's two pieces to this, and I'm not going to tell you that I understand it, but we know that God lives in us. He's always right there. We're a new creation. His Spirit lives in us. And we're also seated with Christ in heavenly places. So we're near to God there because Christ is at the right hand of the Father and we're seated with Christ. So there's, if you look at it as there, we're with him there. If you look at it as here, he's with us here. So I don't understand how all that works. But what I do understand is he's always with us. And no matter what we're going through, God is always with us. That's the first part of it. It's like, dude, he isn't somewhere else. He hasn't turned his back on us. He hasn't walked away. He still is. And we're still seated with him. And there's this thing, and you know, Jesus' prayer was, Father, I just pray that they would be one with us as I am one with you. I mean, it's this oneness with God, and this whole life with God is about a realization of truth. You know, as a man believeth in his heart, so is he. You know, if I go through life understanding that God is with me constantly, my goodness, does that not change everything?
Yes.
Does that not change everything? Every way that I look at people, every moment that I'm alive, every challenge in life, that if I know that God is with me, I look at those things differently. Nothing can separate us from him. Nothing. That's so cool. Not tragedy. Not an earthquake. Not the car payments. Not the house bills. Not the refrigerator going out. Not the neighbor who's angry. Nothing. He's with me. He's with me. And
If I die in this moment, I'm with him in heaven. There's all of a sudden, I see a whole new reality. I come from this reality to that reality. I'm right there with him. Not life nor death can separate us from him. That's pretty cool. It shifts the way we live life, right? Okay, well, time-wise, I'm done, and that's my first point.
Wow.
I've got like 12 of them. This is really weird.
That's a good point.
If you do a series, it means a book will follow.
Maybe so.
Ooh. Yes.
I, you know what? I am going to stop right there. Because that is so important.
Drop the mic. Drop the mic.
What?
You said that.
Think about that. He's right here. He's right there. 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 Wow. We should be so overwhelmed right now. That he's right with us. Wow, I got all of these points. Lord, where do I land this? Because just time-wise, I want to. I know we could keep going, but I know some of you have to get up in the morning. Or we could just stay here all night. You know, there has to be a revelation for each of us of this. Because sometimes we live life like we think he's a long ways away. And he got up this morning over coffee and read the newspaper.
Yeah.
And discovered I had some issues. He discovered you had issues before the creation of time.
Amen.
Yeah.
And he loves you anyway.
Oh, yeah.
That's right.
And he's still with you. Even though you messed up yesterday, even though you had bad thoughts towards somebody, you wanted to punch the guy at the gas station, you watched Fox News and got mad, or you watched CNN and you got even madder, whatever. But you know,
I have something. Sorry to interrupt. I just do, and I can't hold it in any longer.
Okay.
I'll wait, though.
No, you can. It's too late.
Okay, sorry. I've been waiting, because I've been on this all week, and I've been waiting, and the whole service, I'm like, the Lord's like, not yet, not yet, and now it's like, you know, like bursting from my bones. It's just a Bible verse, but I feel like it is exactly what you're saying, and so timely right now. I've been meditating on it all week, and it says that Christ, okay, it says, where am I? That he would grant you according to the riches of his glory to be strengthened with might through his spirit in the inner man. And it says this, that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, and that you being rooted and grounded in love, and it said that we would be able to comprehend the width and length and depth and height and know his love that goes beyond our knowledge. And it says, so basically, we get rooted and grounded in love, and we get, the scripture says, that we would be filled with the fullness of God.
Wow. Yes.
There's something on being filled with the fullness, like the thought of being filled with the very fullness of God, where there would be no sickness, and there would be no hatred, and there would be no anger, and there would be no disease, there would be none of that. Because we're so rooted and grounded in love that we know every depth and every width and every length and every height. And in that place, we receive then the fullness of God.
Wow. That's so good. Wow. Yeah, and that's Ephesians. Being in Ephesians. And in Ephesians 4, in 4, is it 16? Or somewhere where he talks about giving some to be apostles, some prophets, some pastors, teachers, evangelists, for the equipping of the saints, so that we would have the unity of the faith, so that we would have the fullness of Christ again. And it talks about the unity of the body and everybody being equipped. See, that's a huge thing. You know, there's something that's happening right now
where there's a revelation being released on the body of Christ that we all get to play, we all get to be equipped.
Yeah.
And, you know, it all ties together.
Yeah.
But let's pray. Why don't we just stand up? Because I really believe that there's got to be a revelation, a new revelation of that God is with us. And a revelation of His love. He sent His Son to die for us. Now, if that isn't love, I don't know what love is. You know, in fact, He not only loves us, He trusts us. Did you know He chose us to be the vehicles of reconciliation for the world? We're all called to be ministers of reconciliation. He could have sent angels, but instead He chose us.
Yes, He did. Yeah.
Now, in my thinking, angels would have been a better idea. Because I know us. But He's got so much confidence in us that He knew that we could do the job. But it's all got to flow out of that place of intimacy with Him and understanding the depth of His love. See, you're not going to go out on the edge of a cliff unless you know the guy that's got the ability to catch you loves you.
Yeah.
And won't let you fall. He's looking for cliff jumpers. And I don't mean that in a horrible, bad sense. I mean it in, He's looking for people that'll say, I will step off the safe place. I'll step out of that safe place because I know You love me, and I know You're with me, and I know I can trust You. You see, if we come to the knowledge of understanding that we can trust God, if we come to the knowledge of understanding that we can trust God, it changes everything. We got to believe that we can trust Him. We're not going to take risks unless we believe we can trust Him. And I'm here to tell you, He is with you, and you can trust Him. And He's waiting for the moment that you will say, I'm going to take a risk for You. So that you can show yourself powerful for Me and for the world.
Yes.
Father, we need supernatural impartation tonight of a revelation of, first of all, that You really are with us and in us. And that we really are seated at Your right hand in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. We need a revelation and impartation tonight of how amazing Your love is for us. Holy Spirit, come. Show us. Show us in a new way how much You love us. And Lord, let us know that we can trust You. I just pray right now, Lord, even as the early church prayed, Lord, give us more boldness.
Yes.
Shake this place.
Yes.
Shake us.
Yes.
We want more of You, Lord.
Yes. Yes.
We want to be used by You in marvelous ways, new ways. And I pray, Lord, even as we sleep tonight, that there will be dreams released.
Yes, Lord.
That through those dreams, we will have a revelation. We will have a revelation of Your love. We'll have a revelation that we are so connected to You. We'll have a revelation that it's Your desire and Your heart to use us for marvelous, wonderful things. You didn't create us to just live on this earth and die one day. You created us to change the world.
Yes.
Empower us, Lord.
Yes.
I pray that there's not one person that leaves this place without a true knowledge deep in our soul of the love that You have for us. Breathe on us tonight, Holy Spirit. See, the Lord didn't know that, or the Lord knew. He didn't. Lord knew I would only have 10 minutes. But I went a little over. I apologize for that. I would love to have three people come up here as we dismiss. And we're going to go after healing. For those who you had a word of knowledge called about something that you need healing for and you don't feel like you've gotten it yet, these three people are going to be highly anointed. And they're going to be ready to go after your healing. So I need three people. Hello? Three people that are highly anointed for healing. Let's see. Every person in this room, if you know Jesus, you have the same power within you that raised Jesus from the dead. Who wants to pray? I'm not, we're not excusing anybody until we get three people up here. All right, Monica. We need two more anointed healers. And if you just need a prophetic word, they'll give that to you too. Wow. One more. Come on. Okay, I'll be up here. I'll take a risk. Well, I just want to pray a blessing over you. Hey, I just challenge you to get a word for somebody before you leave tonight. An encouraging word. Really, we just need to just continue to go after the things of the kingdom. That's what we're created for, to walk in power and to walk as the great encouragers that he's called us to be. And so I just bless everybody here. Thank you for coming. And I just say, Father, I just pray that doors of opportunity would open for each and every one of us this week to just share Jesus and to encourage somebody, to pray with somebody for healing, Lord, to give them a prophetic word. And I just pray, Lord, that we just choose to love people well this week.
Yes.
Really well. Dangerously well. In Jesus' name. Love you guys. Thanks for coming. Bless you.